chairman and executive members of the Ghana Christian Council, United Kingdom and Ireland, Reverend ministers, particularly the Most Reverend Titus Awotchiprat, leading a delegation of bishops from the Methodist Church in Ghana, and of course, our host, Superintendent Minister, Reverend Dr. Martin Atkins. Nananu, Chair and Board Members of the Ghana Union UK, my compatriots, on behalf of His Excellency Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo, President of the Republic of Ghana, I bring you good greetings, felicitations, and congratulations on our 65th anniversary as an independent nation. We must thank God for having brought us this far. Many nations in Africa envy Ghana, but for us in Ghana, we know that there's far more that we can do as a nation. When we became independent, we believed that the sky was the limit. The potential was there. Yes, our forebears sacrificed, gave us political independence. We've gone through a lot as a country in terms of our governance, but now we can proudly say that we are a stable, multi-party, constitutional democracy that believes in the use of the ballot to change our leadership. But now, we also look forward and wonder whether we are drifting. If after 60 years of independence, we can say that we are indeed an independent country. Going forward, our president says, let us move Ghana beyond aid. Moving Ghana beyond aid involves a change in mindset. Moving Ghana beyond aid means rediscovering those values that made our forebears risk their lives to let us be independent politically. Moving Ghana beyond aid is using our intellectual power as a diaspora to collaborate with those of our compatriots at home to make a difference to our country. Just this afternoon, the Methodist Church, led by the Presiding Bishop, honored missionaries who had gone to Ghana and served the Methodist Church for 26 years. But when we look at our history as a country, missionaries sacrificed and through them, through Christianity, established education institutions of which we are beneficiaries, established hospitals, gave us care, and they even knew at the time they were going, as Reverend Dr. Martin Atkins reminded us some time ago, they even knew when they were going that they were going to die. Yes, they went to the West African coast, the white man's grave. We here are among the beneficiaries. Now our nation is calling upon us. If at a time of political independence, Kuma, Akwaji, etc. Sergeant Ajete and so forth, who have had global exposure, leading the way. Now is the time for the diaspora to lead the way towards moving Ghana beyond it. We can't have an excuse, because Ghana is our country. If others came to our country, faced death just to bring us what they consider to be enlightenment, for those of us who've had global exposure, it is the time for us not to look at the cost, but see it as a duty, wherever we are, to help our country move beyond aid. Government is committed to the diaspora. So that's what the diaspora desk at the office of the president, headed by someone who has been in the diaspora for over 30 years, to collaborate with the diasporas, to engage, to see how best we can benefit from your skills, knowledge, and of course, your financial resources. Going further, government has committed itself to assisting the Electoral Commission to implement the provisions of the Representations of the People's Act, ROPA, which gives Ghanaians resident outside Ghana the right to vote in elections. That is a very sure way for you to play a meaningful role in the future of our country. And to the Ghana Christian Council, thank you so much for organizing this service that has brought Ghanaians in the United Kingdom from far and near, of various denominations. And the unity of the Christian community is symbolized by the new Mass Pact. Let us work together. Let us see ourselves as one. And bear in mind that it is only by His grace that we come this far as a nation. Look back at yourself. Had it not been for God and the saving grace of His Son Jesus Christ, where would we have been as a nation? Where would we have been as individuals? Thank you so much for coming. And as you leave, commit yourself to work for your country, Ghana. As we all look resplendent in our colorful attire, let us resolve that we will continue seeking God's face, and that our life will be reflective of the colorful clothing we wear. It is my prayer that Almighty God will prosper you as individuals. It is my fervent prayer that the Ghanaian men of God will continue winning souls for Christ, more so those who are here, who have heard the word, but have hardened their hearts. It is a call. If over 200 years ago, missionaries came from Britain to Ghana, I dare say that at this stage in our life, God is calling upon us to let here see the fruits of the seeds that are sowed in God. Continue praying for leadership for your country. It is not easy. There are examples in the Bible, men who have been called by God, and after in their mouths of God, it tells you that leadership is challenging. However, we are resolved to make a difference to our country. We thank God for Ghana and our celebration. And may the Almighty God continue to bless our homeland Ghana and make our nation great and strong. Most Reverend Titus, you know there's a song, it was written by Reverend Kadelapa, Amen, Son of Jesus.